no idea how you're feeling, man. It looks like you're quickly becoming a fan favorite out here, man. What is the love feeling like right now?
Feeling hungry, man. For some food, really. Yeah, but it's, I didn't expect as many people, but it feel good.
I think a lot of people are really looking forward to this fight. Does this feel like a special fight, you and Roy Nelson?
Each and every fight to me in the UFC is special. You know, they say I shouldn't be here. Should never got here, but it feel damn good to be here, though.
Going into this fight, obviously, a lot of people are saying that Roy's big advantage is the grappling area. At the open workout, you showed off a few moves there. Have you been working on your grappling pretty hard going into this one? And how much do you feel it's improved going into this fight?
I believe it improved big time, you know. I'm a blue belt now, but a lot of people don't know that. But I really just hate the ground game anyways. You know, I know a lot of submissions. I know a lot of defense. But I just hate submitting a guy. I just like knocking him out, make him look like he had too many beers, you know, make him look drunk. I just like knocking people out.
You feel, I mean, Roy obviously is known for his knockout power, but known for that grappling as well. Do you feel like it would be kind of a chicken oven, I guess, to try to take you to the ground? Do you feel like it's a fight where he should stand and engage and just see who lands first?
You know, I'm a brawler, so it don't matter where the fight goes. I'm always looking for the knockout. I could be on my back, I'm still looking for my back.
You're the only fighter in UFC history that's had their first 8 fights one way or another ended in a knockout. What does that kind of just say about your style and how UFC can trust you every time they put you out there to have a fight that ends that way?
Like I said before, the UFC know I'm coming in, give me all I got, kill or be killed. You know? So I love it, they love it. So we're going to keep rolling.
Derek Roy was up here, he calls you the Black Fedor. What does that mean?
I don't know. I never even really seen Fedor fight. You know, I just seen a couple of highlights, that's about it. I really don't even know Fedor. So. Is he good?
Very good.
You know, shit. I'm Black Fedor, right?
Well, speaking of the heavyweight landscape in the UFC, there's a lot of crazy things happening. You know, Stipe's fighting Overeem. You've got this huge matchup between Mark Hunt and Brock Lesnar, also UFC 200. What are your thoughts on that matchup? Brock Lesnar coming back, fighting Mark Hunt. Are you excited to see Brock back in the division, back in the UFC?
Yeah, you know, but Brock Lesnar's not a fighter, you know. He's scared to get hit, you know. But depends on how this fight goes. If the fight goes, my fight goes the way I want it to go on Thursday, I would like to win it.
Will you be there in attendance at 200 after this fight? And if so, will you try and sort of play towards getting that fight after the fight if Brock does win?
You know how much the tickets is? Shit. I was going to be at a bar around here watching. I'm not paying that much for the damn tickets.
What about that Brock fight?
You know, I like Mark. You know, he's just like Roy. You know, he come out and fight, you know, swing and bang. And I'm going with Mark on this fight.
So you want to fight Brock
instead? Hell yeah, man, I'll fight anyway. You know, the reason why I call out Roy, this is a more realistic fight, you know. Ain't no way I could really call out the champ in the UFC take him seriously. But I feel like Roy is like closer to my, I guess, rank in a way. So I believe they gave me the fight.
Derek, you feel like that day is coming?
Will you call me Roy?
No.
Next. Next.
Derek, you feel like that day is coming, though, where you can't call the champ?
What?
You feel like that day is coming, though, when you can call out the champ?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I believe after this fight right here that I'm going to put on a real good performance, you know. I believe probably next year I'm going to step in short notice, right? These guys falling out left and right, saying they broke their toenails, stuff like that. So be ready.
On top of being an exciting fighter and a knockout artist, you've seemed to gain a lot of traction for your social media, Instagram, Twitter. How do you come up with all that stuff? Is it just,
I said it earlier. It's really Adam Sandler. You know, he just gave me the confirmation. Yeah, you go ahead and post that, Adam. So it's really him, not me.
Is it out of pressure, though, because you are more in the spotlight? Fans have taken a big liking to you. Do you feel any extra pressure? Obviously, it's a huge fight weekend going into this fight.
I really don't do this for the fans, you know. The fans are wishing well, especially in the MMA. It's like this, an NFL team, nothing like that. As soon as you lose a couple of fights, you don't even have them same fans. You know, in like NFL, football, MMA, stuff like that, you lose a few games, you still have your fans. But I'm not doing it for my fans. I'm really doing it for my family.
How do you see your first one to be here. Who were some of the people that doubted you along the way? What did people say about that?
I don't know who it was doubting. I just heard he say, she say, you know, and it just motivated me to work harder.
Why do you think they doubted you?
I don't know. It's more politics.
There's not a lot of young talent at heavyweight in the UFC currently. Do you look around and say, you're the guy, you're the top prospect in this division?
No, I don't look at it like that. Like I say, I'm really doing it to take care of my family. I'm not trying to be the best fighter out there, you know. I'm just trying to, you know, put food on the table. That's all.
What kind of money would make you happy, you know, fighting, climbing up the ranks?
Conor McGregor type money, Conor, you know. McGregor. Yeah, for sure. I've been taking naked pictures, stuff like that, you know.
It's interesting you mentioned you're not a fan of Bader. Are you a fan of MMA at all? If you weren't a fighter, would you be watching it? Would you be at the events? Would you be supporting other fighters?
I really hate watching fights, you know. If it's not a heavyweight fight, I really don't watch it. So, I don't give a damn about
it. When you mentioned, did you see the fight between Cain Velasquez and Travis Brown?
I believe Cain Velasquez really got to win his fight because, like, you haven't really heard anything about him fighting this fight. They ain't promote him at all, so I believe the Golden Boy, the UFC, I don't know. You know, I don't really want to say too much.
Would you be interested in the winner of that fight?
I fight anyone, you know. It doesn't matter. So I'll be ready. I'm always ready. That's why I'm the most active heavyweight in the UFC right now. I'm always ready. No matter who they are, I'm ready to go.
Yeah, this will be your ninth fight since you got in the UFC. No one's fought more. No heavyweight's fought more than five times in that stretch. Do you want a little break at any point, or are you just happy to keep the ball rolling?
I'm ready to go all the time. Yeah. It doesn't matter.
Do you love to back in all your gym members talking about it? I was wondering if there's been any added inspiration in trying to do something in Montgomery for the UFC.
No, I'm going in to fight. Same mentality that went in my last fight. You know, I'm going to give it all I got. So I know he would have been screaming top of his lungs, telling me, push, Derek, push, go forward. So I know that's what I'm going to do.
Has this camp been any different without him?
No, man, the camp been the same.
Obviously, you're an exciting fighter. This is a big fight for you. But do you feel like the UFC is pushing your name enough and pushing you enough? You mentioned how you felt like Cain Velasquez was the Golden Boy. Do you feel like the UFC are pushing you more now and giving you the promotion that you deserve?
Of course not. No shit. I don't got no Reebok sponsorship like some of these other guys coming in. Probably only had two fights and they're already getting a Reebok contract. But, you know, it is what it is. But I know I just got to keep working. Don't worry about all that little stuff, you know. Just keep going forward.
Thank you
very
much.
Where BET at? Y'all got all these other money. Where BET?
Black Sports.
Man. You know, when the Latinos fighting, y'all got Telemundo and everything. Black Sports, where you
at? There's like three of us here all the time. Right. Everybody else can't make it yet. I'm here early. Not like our people. I got you.
The Australians have you back, don't worry.